thought and gave everybody a chance to sit back down. Our second scripture this morning is taken from Ephesians 5:19. Speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, sing and make music from your heart to the Lord. Such wonderful words. You know, I also told myself that I wasn't going to spend a great deal of time with the message this morning because of the message we're receiving through the hymns, but again, I'm sorry, what preacher can resist? So we are going to say a little something this morning. You know, the Bible lists seven reasons why singing should matter. In the Bible, it says singing isn't an option. It says singing is a command from God. God's people in His Word, in the Bible, are more than just invited to sing. We are commanded to sing. And when we sing, we are doing what God asks us. Number two, when you sing, you dig deep into the roots of God's Word. The scripture says, let the words of Christ dwell in you richly. Dwell in you richly. And singing is one of the ways that God's Word does dwell in us. Our singing is more than just a warm-up for the sermon or a fill-in piece for the service. This verse in Colossians is clearly laying out for us that singing stands in importance besides preaching. It is one of the two great ways that God has ordained for His Word to be heard. C.J. Mahaney calls church singing take-home theology. And I think this is important because you might not take home a single word I said. But how about those songs that you've heard over and over and over again as a child and now as an adult? How many times can you walk out of this church, probably won't be able to give one word of what I have to say today, but you'll be walk out of the same of this church singing one of those old hymns. Or you'll catch yourself maybe sometimes at home in a little time of trouble just singing a little hymn just to lift those spirits back up. You know, it helps us memorize parts of the Bible. You know, memorizing God's Word is an important part of being a Christian. The Bible has a lot to say in it. And it's hard sometimes to read it, but as we each probably have our own scripture that we love and we can quote it word from the Bible. Can't do the whole Bible there, but memorizing that scripture is so important. It's that take-home theology. You know, I'm surprised we aren't singing this song today, but one song that comes to mind that I catch myself singing a lot is In Christ Alone. I see heads nodding. See? What did I say last week in the sermon? You see what I mean? God's Word. Take-home theology. The third thing is when you sing, you build up others. You know, how many times have you caught yourself in a bad place or something like that, and then you start into a little bit of a song. And maybe it isn't a church song, but it's a song. A song from your childhood. You know, a song that just made you happy when you heard it. And find yourself singing it or humming it, and then all of a sudden you hear from two stacks away or behind you, you hear somebody else joining in. Because it's building them up also. And that's what God's Word does. We don't keep God's Word to ourselves. We don't keep God's songs to ourselves. We pass them on. They will build others up as they build us up also. You might not know this, but you know that when you sing, you make war. How about that? What do you think about that? When you sing, you make war. What is we talked about hymns being God's word. Who are we at war against? The devil, the world, I can give you a list. Sin. So when we use song, it's kind of like our sword and our shield, isn't it? It's our sword and shield against the evils of this world. Our sword and shield against the devil himself. You know what? When the devil hears us singing, he's nowhere in sight. It's when you're alone and you're quiet and you're by yourself with your troubles. That's when the devil sneaks in. So lift your voice in song. There is power. Power in song. Power in God's word. And when you sing, you are spiritually strengthened for the trials that you know are going to come or that are already there. You know, many times in the Bible, it talks about those that were in prison, those that were being persecuted for God, being locked in prison, and the fact of being in that dark, deep prison with no light and little or no food and just themselves there. Many times the disciples, those being persecuted by God, for God, excuse me, talk about singing, and their captors were amazed that their voices were being lifted up. They even had musical instruments. The Bible talks about one point in time where, as they sang, they would clank their chains together for the music. What power! Even in the midst of our trials, and how many times have you heard that saying, you know, that you know, you ain't going to make it any better by whining and complaining about it? But when you open up your heart, when you open up your voice and sing, how many times does it make you feel better? You know, back in a long, long time ago, back when the slaves were working the fields, and then they just had no end to their labor in sight, they would lift their voice in song. Their slavery could not put them down. The devil cannot put us down if we raise our voices in song. And when you sing, you walk God's pathway to joy. Isn't that an amazing thing? You walk God's pathway to joy. Just listen to these few verses from Psalms that talk about this. Psalms is such a powerful book. Psalms 5:11, let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let them ever sing for joy and spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may exalt in you. Psalms 9:2, I will be glad and exalt in you. I will sing praise to your name, O Most High. Psalm 63:7, for you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I will sing for joy. Joy. Such a message. Such a powerful tool that we can use. And when you sing, last of all, but one of the most important things, when you sing, you glorify God. You've heard, many of you have heard me say that singing is like praying twice. There is such power in song. There's such a prayer in song. We're glorifying our God. We're lifting up His name. You know, it kind of brings our heart, our soul, our mind, and our strength together. That's what song is. It focuses our attention on God. It takes our mind off the clang and the clamor and the noise around us, or the silence around us that reminds us that we're not in a good place. And it focuses our attention back on God. Blessed assurance Jesus is God. You know, through song, you can even get a glimpse of eternity. The Bible in Revelation talks to us about choirs of angels lifting their voices in song. It reminds us that God at the end is waiting for us and his angels will be singing. Yes, eternity awaits. I want to know, will all of you on that day be one of that great number, that uncountable number of people that will be singing God's song, that will be singing his praises and be singing to him, be singing the glory and the riches and the abundance that he has left with you. So I tell you now today to sing now. I tell you to sing forever. Forever. Because singing matters. And it also matters that we do it together. As God's children, as God's church.